life-size figure that's going to be Parker, the Minuteman. As you can see, the underside, the inside of the armature is made from PVC pipe. I use the PVC pipe because it's really easy to bend and move. I just heat it with a heat gun, and I can bend it, and then when it cools down, it hardens, and it's in the shape I need, and it's strong enough to hold the clay on it. And so it's easier than welding. I'm in an old historic building, and I don't think welding would be very wise. I'd probably burn it down. So the PVC pipe works well for me. I covered the PVC pipe in foam, and that's just purely to take up space, so I'm not using so much clay. There's no need to cover this whole old PVC pipe with clay. It'd be very heavy and a lot of clay. I'd use way hundreds of pounds more clay than I need to use. I have to paint this. This is a real dense, fine foam, and the clay won't stick to it. So I will paint this just so the clay will stick to it. And then I put the clay on it. I make all of the figures nude so that I know that the anatomy is there. If you can see this chart here, I have measured the actor who's playing Parker, and I have all of the dimensions I need for him. This piece is actually going to be about 6 feet tall, which is a little taller than the actor. So I've sort of stretched it and made him a little bit larger from his measurements. But I do have the correct proportions down here. I will make sure that the figure is made anatomically correct and nude before I start putting the clothes on. So you'll see some of the progress as I go along. I'll keep filming so you'll see how I'm going. I also, as I said before, I make the head separately. It's just a lot easier to work on it when it's not way up here, and I can work on it on, I can see all sides of it when it's off and down and make sure I've got all the proportions correct. So, this is the beginning. This is how it starts.